Hey guys, welcome to Trapping World. If you want to help support the channel, go to the home page and you know what to do. There's a couple buttons there you can push if you're so inclined. Alrighty, enjoy the show. Stay safe, keep your boots dry. Hey guys, we're going to do somebody asked me on the channel about, just hang on. Need coffee. About traps for, or pans for mink traps and whatnot. So I'm going to, I don't use them a lot anymore. Just because I'm lazy, I think. But I bought some last year. Didn't like them. I'm taking them all off. So I'm going to make some like I used to make when I was 16 years old. You know, when I was young, my family didn't have much money. I generally had what I needed to go trapping, just from me collecting pop bottles at first and stuff and having a paper route. Okay, anyways, I guess I should just see here. I've just taken a little square piece of tin like this, a scrap tin. You're going to want it so that it's fairly solid, okay? Not flimsy, because if it'll bend easily, then that bending takes some of the pressure off of the pan tension, okay? So you want it fairly solid. I cut it into a shape like so. I've got two cameras going here, by the way, in case this camera that's on my head doesn't capture the video. So then you cut this little notch here. This is an important piece right here. Put it in a vise. Just bend it down 90 degrees. Okay. Then you take whatever trap you're using. Like you can put these on. I'm going to put this one on a 160. What the heck. I'm going to straighten this trigger out. I'll get my big pliers here. Okay, so straighten the trigger out as best you can. I wanted to try setting some Fisher and Martin sets with pans anyway, so this will give me an opportunity. I got lots of traps, so. Now you get this fairly straight, okay? Now, whatever this distance is here, see that each trap is different by not much, but a little bit. So, you know, that distance there, what you're going to want to do is you take a nail, like so, and right level. So you put your nail like that and punch a hole right through there. Hand. You know, make sure it's big enough for that wire to go through, like so. Okay? And then you punch another one at about the distance that is away. Okay? Come back here. So now you've got your two holes. Now what you're going to want to do is you can decide if you want your trap inside or your pan on the inside or on the outside of the trap. Over the years of using it, I figured it's much better to be on the inside, and I'll explain why after. So what you do is decide how high up off the bottom you want it. And I like to go, you know, 3/4 of an inch, an inch. You can go bigger on these bigger traps. That gives you them less room for them to sneak in. And bend your trigger to 90 degrees. like so. Okay? And now you take your pan, put it in the trigger in like that. So you see now you've got your trigger or your pan sitting like so, right? And move it in so that the wire is right out at the edge. That's going to give you your best best whatever you want to call it, tension or ease of springing. And you can also make a little bend here and another little bend here. Like that. Now you do want to have a heat shield in here because we're going to be doing some soldering. Or you'll just end up catching your block there on fire. I should have went and got a vice grip too. So now you're going to take a little bit of flux, and put it on here where you're going to be soldering, and on here. Now that one there is that trap spring is a little bit bent, so I got to clamp, get it down there so the solder will grab. Okay. Now we're going to get your solder, your torch, and start heating up that pan. Now you are going to have to clean that solder off after, obviously, because and this thing needs to be as level as you can possibly make it, or else the solder just does what it's doing and runs off. More solder. Now I know somebody's going to ask, you know, how do you stop the pan from flying off when it springs, but I've never had one that's, you know, been soldered properly come off. So okay, just let her cool down. I got some cool down water right over here. Okay, so now paper towel. You don't want to do this right before trapping season because this flux, I imagine, will smell somewhat to a mink or a fish or a marten or whatever you're trying to catch. So, you know, leave it outside and let it get cleaned off. And now you have your pan. So you see. Now, this pan I would use for a 120. You know, not a 220. Or this is a 160. But I would make it a little bit bigger for a 160. Now, the reason, and I'm going to show you here, that you go on the inside, is if you have the trap pan pointing out here, sticking out like this, on the 120s especially, this one here, there's probably clearing, but that trap is going to go off, and if the animal's coming from this way and he has his front feet here, that trap will go off and that bottom jaw is going to throw up the pan, and it will, at, you know, quite often actually throw the animal right out of the path. So with this way, the trap is going, the pan is going down, the jaws are going this way, and it actually sucks the animal into the trap. Okay? Now, I did one yesterday with a one, I'm not going to do that 160 spring it with my hands. So, but I did it on a, you know, that one there, the 160 I just did is a Belial. I did it on a one of these LDL traps yesterday on the 120s. Okay? Now I'm going to show you what I mean about the trap catch as soon as I have another sip of coffee. So you've got an animal comes, you know, and puts his front feet in here, right here. You've got his head is right here. So this is where you're going to end up catching him. Right across the top of the front legs. Okay, now I'm going to reset this thing. Yeah, my trap setter, the spring, got lost somewhere this winter, so I got to get a new one to put on there. Okay, so now we'll show you when it's going the other way. Okay, so now you've got an animal coming from the other side, and he's all the way through the trap. His front legs are right on the pan now, and so his head's out here. Okay, so this will be his head. And so you're getting a good catch again with the pan on the inside like that. Okay? And that is quite a snap. But anywho, so like I said, there, you know, is an easy way to make some pans for your traps if you want to make your own. Like I said, I always just went to the, you know, wherever I could and got scrap metal. And you see, this one here is welded on or soldered on a little better. You know, if you don't want to solder too, you can just drill holes on each side, put a pop rivet in there with a washer on it. One here, one here, one here, and one here, and that'll hold it in place. You know, fairly good. It won't, definitely won't go anywhere anyways. But, like I said, I'm going to give a few of these. I'm going to put, probably make a dozen, maybe a dozen of each with the pans and just see how it works. But, like I said, I'm going to go for a wider pan. And yeah, I should have adjusted that for, see that this is a little higher than I want it on this one, on the 160s and the 220s, because right in here that gives enough room for mink to weasel their way through there, and weasels to weasel their way through too. So anyways, Cool. Oh yeah, I want to get that off there, don't I? Yeah, see that one? Yeah, one side of that broke loose. I've got to re-solder that so that the solder is over top of the wire. That's not on there enough. But see, this is also why I put these holes in here. Even if the solder breaks off, those holes are going to, you know, the wire's going to stay on the pan. And then you can, you know, re-solder it or put pop rivets in or whatever you want. That's that just needs to be redone. This one here is, it's fired about, you know, 8 or 9 times already. So anyways, muy bueno. And I got to get to doing some beavers now. Got 3 beavers to flesh and board, and then that one beaver that I caught today, skin and board. So, alrighty, groovy, later.